picture of a ship sailing straight towards you. A prow was gilded and shaped like the head of a dragon with wide open mouth. She had only one mast and one large square sail, which was a rich purple. The sides of the ship, what you could see of them where the gilded wings of the dragon ended, were green. 463 days to go. Production has started. I still can't quite believe it after the whole will it be made or not phase, but the past months a lot of photos appeared of the main set piece, the Dawn Treader. I'm only using a few in this video, so if you want to see them all, just go to narniaweb.com and type Dawn Treader pics. You'll get all the news posts with the new Dawn Treader pics. It's really interesting to see the progress. It is worth your time. In this video I'll be discussing the Dawn Treader design only, from head to tail if you will, and I really like it a lot. It's not the way I imagined it, but I think it's just as good. So let's start with the most recognizable features: the prow, the tail, the sail, and of course the colors. First off, it's in the shape of a dragon, hooray! Of course that was to be expected, but still you can never be sure enough. I like the shape of the head, it's really recognizable, and it feels iconic like in the book. It really feels fairy tale like, I really support that. This story is a fairy tale, it's a story for children. Andrew Adamson, the director of the first two Narnia films, said that they were making a movie for the child in all of us, after which he decided to extend some battles and add some battles and add a romance between Susan and Caspian. So you know, maybe this time around they actually make that phrase come true. And maybe they really, really are able to make a great movie out of this one. And if I see these pictures, I really start to believe that. I'm not completely happy with the dragon wings. I always thought they would be a bit bigger, and I thought they would have a different shape, like in the Pauline Baynes illustration in the movie, because it almost has the shape of the wave that you get when the water is split apart by the prow. And that might look really cool. I do think the entire boat is a little bit too big. You know, if you look at this person here, you realize how huge it is. I mean, isn't that a little bit too big? You know, the tail is alright, it's a little too big at the beginning, but I'm just really happy that it's there. It's really exactly as it is described in the book, the entire ship. And then there is the sail. It's a purple sail. How amazing is that? The color of the sail is exactly what makes it the Dawn Treader for me. I'm not able to imagine a Dawn Treader without a purple sail. Try to imagine a Dawn Treader with a sail in a different color than purple. It's just impossible. And if I love the purple they use still. It's not too bright because that would make it almost pink. It's really a darker, almost blue-like. And it's exactly the way I imagine it, so I'm really happy with it. There are two masts. One's probably gonna be bigger than what we see now because of this mysterious rigging they added. It's pretty safe to say that it will be bigger. The other one is a little shorter than the first, and it has a lamppost on top. It looks a lot like the lamppost of the first movie, but it fits well on top of this mast. So I like it. It's okay. Because of the lamppost, you know this one won't be digitally enlarged like the other one. And because there is no rigging or beam, it's pretty sure to say that this mast won't get a sail. There only will be one sail and two masts. In the book, the boat is described as being green with a golden prow. In the movie, it is the prow that is primarily green with some gold parts in it too. The ship is primarily brown red with some green and gold curls, and I love that. You know, if you would have an entire ship painted green, it might feel some kind of spooky, like it's glowing in the dark or something. While this ship is supposed to be really beautiful, and I think they handled that perfectly. I mean, adding this brown color that's really amazing too. I really like it. I love the details. It all looks so amazing, and it makes me believe that this movie might be a true to the source movie, which are quite rare, but amazing nonetheless.